And please keep in mind that these meetings are televised live, so when you approach the podium, please let us know who you are, which business you represent, and you can lay your plans out on the desk right next to the podium. So before we get started, we're going to start our meeting with Cindy Ritz leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag, the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have a large agenda tonight, so we'll try to move it through as quickly as we can here. So our first application tonight is DRB 2016-15, the application of the Goatsbeard at 103 North Wayne Avenue in Wayne, zoned under the Wayne Business Overlay District for outside dining. Okay. And the Goatsbeard was here last month, and we're continuing discussions tonight. So, hi, guys. Hi,
I'm Sean Coyle from the Goatsbeard.
Hello, and I'm Mike McCrory, his partner.
Okay. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
Okay. So, I guess last month we did approve some things, but we did ask you to come back this month to clarify a couple things also.
That's correct.
So, just to backtrack a little bit, I think we pretty much approved everything to the building facade and changes to the building facade. Is there any changes this month on that?
No, not at all.
Okay, so we're strictly dealing with the outside dining this month.
That's correct.
Okay, good. All right, great. So
I think we were asked to bring some cut sheets or for
yes.
lighting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
But yeah.
Right, just to make sure that Ray gets those for the township files.
Gotcha.
Right. Okay.
And what we'd like to maybe start with is what we've taken away from before.
Mm-hmm.
All the flower pots that were out there, all those string lights, mm-hmm. anything that connected to the string lights, and along with the wood wall that we were
okay.
putting up between us and our neighbor, have all been eliminated now from the drawing.
Okay, terrific.
Okay,
make life easier for us. Thanks.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, it's just what the furniture is and what the lighting is, and you see the cut sheets,
mm-hmm.
And what that fabric color will look like.
You also changed the fencing as well. You lowered the fencing.
The fencing we left as is. Before, what we were proposing was to add some posts to the fence
correct.
To hold the lights, and we've eliminated
mm-hmm.
that. So
okay.
the antique fence that's there today will
yeah,
remain
okay.
as is.
Yeah.
Okay.
We got to bring this.
That seems a little easier.
Yeah.
So where would you like to start with the furniture? What would you like us to start with?
Why don't we look at the furniture?
Okay, the furniture is going to be the exact same furniture that was out there before, same make, same material.
Mm-hmm.
The only difference in it will be the color. We are going with, I think it is called...
Canyon Cocoa.
Canyon Cocoa will be the color. It's an espresso color, so both the pad and the chair itself will be in the espresso color range.
Tables
will be the same material as the chairs themselves. So
okay.
if you were ever at Cilantro or saw what Cilantro
right.
was,
mm-hmm.
that same type of furniture, the same make and material, be
yep.
the same exact make and material that was there before.
Was it like a heavy wicker that they
heavy
had?
Heavy wicker, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, good. Okay,
but
you got
synthetic.
Synthetic, correct.
It wears well.
Correct.
The I know the cushions, they're going to have to be okayed by the township community development just for fire hazards and stuff.
Okay.
Okay, so...
No problem.
They'll check that out just to make sure it meets
no
code.
Problem. Is that
right.
something we do through you guys or through zoning? Or
Probably through Ray's office.
Okay,
yeah, community
great.
Development.
And Ray, we would just submit a cut sheet of that to you. You review it and
yep.
great.
All right, good.
Okay.
Okay, so we're good with that? The chairs, tables yep. and all? Okay, great.
Mm-hmm.
Moving across to the sconces.
Mm-hmm.
This gives you an idea of what the sconce is. Edison bulb light, really, you know, like a nice... soft lit warm light that will be attached
yeah.
to a metal fixture on either side of the door.
Mm-hmm.
So we're proposing two of those.
Looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Right, that,
yep.
It's
okay,
very
good.
Nice looking.
Great.
I love that.
Thank you. From there, if you're coming across, you'll see the uplight. The uplight will be for the sign.
Mm-hmm.
In your package there, it shows what the sign is, the material that it's made out of. The sign is going to be lit two ways. One is backlit through some LED lights,
mm-hmm.
and then uplit through this the little light right here.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Good.
Any questions or comments there?
It's very nice.
Good.
Okay.
Go back to the
Yeah, good point. Going back to the tables, chairs, the umbrella, we're looking for wood pole umbrella. We have a sombrella parchment color. It's in a cream color. It's in your cut sheet as well.
Okay.
And that, you know, you can see, sorry, go ahead.
Just no advertising on the umbrella.
No advertising at all, plain.
Okay, good.
And the awnings were, I think, approved last time?
Yes.
Black, charcoal, black family, we're still...
Were you going to put some lettering on the awning?
We have shown you on our drawing to potentially put the goat's beard on it. Candidly, we don't know if we want to do it or not, because it says the goat's beard right above it in the sign, so having it in two places, I don't know if it does anything for us to put it twice.
Should we approve it, just give them the option?
Why don't we approve it? You can put your website on it, too, if you want.
That's something we'd be open to.
Letters, nine-inch letters.
Yeah.
Eight-inch.
Eight-inch, I think, is what's allowed, yeah.
Yep. Right on the front, on the front facade.
Right.
Yeah, on the front drop.
Correct.
Yeah, so you're allowed to put address, website, name of the business.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
All right, so we'll give you the option at either or.
Thank you.
Address, website, name of the business.
Okay.
The material for the awning itself, is that...
That is...
Is it flame resistant?
Is this umbrella?
Is it flame resistant, the material itself?
I can look at my email. I'm not positive. I'm sure it is.
Okay.
And that's pretty standard.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Is it umbrella? Do you know?
Yeah, I believe it was.
I think it is.
Umbrella, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's flame resistant.
Got it.
We'll definitely double check that, but I'm pretty sure.
Okay, good. All right. And what else?
That's it. If there's any other comments or questions, we're here to answer them for you, but... I know there were some concerns the first time around. We anything that, you know, didn't meet zoning or was a concern, we've eliminated from that.
I appreciate that. Yeah. Makes things a little easier for us. Yeah. And for Radnor Township. So. Yeah. Okay.
So, just one question. So the your neighboring building before, so before you had some sort of a wood wall. Yes, that's eliminated.
That's been totally eliminated.
Okay.
Pulled out. It'll look exactly what it is. We were happy to see them. They're actually in the process of painting their building.
Okay.
That's ongoing right now.
Okay. Looks great.
Cindy, other
questions, no, I was just comments? Looking at sunbrella. I think it's fire resistant.
Great.
But I just, I think it's a great looking project. I'm looking forward to it opening. Thank you for making the changes. Design-wise, they looked great, but thank you for complying with the code.
Yeah. Thank you.
You guys are still shooting for June opening?
Yes. Hopefully,
for the jazz festival?
Hopefully earlier.
Hopefully open by the, what's 11. The, yeah.
Yes, we'd like to be open.
With the event,
we'd
know?
Be like to be open a couple weeks before the event.
That'd be great.
Yes, you don't want to open it. Yes. Mayhem, yeah.
Yes.
No, it'd be great. I like
okay,
it.
Okay, good.
Great.
All right.
Yep.
Who wants to make the approval?
Do you want to make the motion?
Sure. For the motion for DRB 2016-15, the goat's head beer for the proposal of signage, changes in the signage as well as facade and outdoor patio furniture. I approve.
Okay.
And do I hear a second?
There is a second.
Second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Great. Thanks again, guys.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
I might just check again because there's like all these different fabrics, but
well,
just look.
I'll make sure.
Yeah. Thanks. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, next on the agenda tonight is DRB 2016-13, the application of B Restaurant at 372 West Lancaster Avenue in Wayne for ground sign, four wall signs, awnings, facade renovation, and outside dining. Hello there.
Hello, I'm Jim Bray, representing B Wayne.
Okay.
And came in from Boulder, Colorado today to your wonderful town, which this is my third time here and
great place.
Okay,
is
good.
That the headquarters, or is that are there a number of B restaurants?
They are out of Connecticut, believe it or not.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to plug this in, and we're going to find out what happens. All right, there we go.
Jim, I guess you want to start with the building renovations?
Yeah, why don't I start with the building renovations. So as you guys may or may not be aware, Carmel's that was in there for roughly a year, folded up and went away. And so basically, Plan B is, or B. Wayne is looking to assume their lease, come in and make some improvements. They again liked this location very much. They looked in this area for quite some time. They looked at King of Prussia and some other locations and felt that they really wanted to be part of the community. And so they chose this location and liked the fact that it was an existing restaurant location and that they could come in and make some improvements and get down the road with it. So basically, we are not making any major improvements to the envelope of the building. Right now, we're talking about making a patio improvement where there currently is not one. Carmel's had already gotten rights to do that patio before, but did not do it. So in addition to making the patio improvements, what we've done is basically gone onto the exterior and try to make some improvements to the exterior that were kind of bringing the brand online. And then honestly, what we thought were some kind of basic improvements to give it some more pedestrian scale, some better feel to it. Mm-hmm. So what we've done, and let me see if I can kind of zoom in here.
I might have missed something. Are you related to the previous business? Is your company related to that? Okay,
No. Let me clarify my relationship because that should be clear. So I'm representing B. Wayne.
Yes.
I am their architect. Mm-hmm. I've been working with this client for a little over 2 years. Mm-hmm. And so this is, you know, we have basically we've come out here, looked at the building a couple times, and then we've been working with them to come up with this design concept. To represent their brand at the existing building.
How many restaurants do they have?
They have about 8. So they're not a huge chain. So they're very specifically looking for specific locations. They're doing kind of one a year. So
and this is basically their only brand, or do they have other restaurants?
They actually have, in Connecticut, they have, as most restaurateurs, they end up with a couple other brands of tea shops and coffee shops and a couple other pieces. Okay. But they're not out there to try to produce 40 of these and franchise them or anything like that. Okay. So this is a specifically small brand that they're trying to develop. And they're not a mega conglomerate. They're two guys. So what we've done to the exterior is we've removed these large sign box panels. There was one that was over here at the on the north side, and then there was another one at the entrance. And what we've tried to do is create kind of a lower slung roof here that is also working as kind of a signage banner, but also kind of grounding the building, really defining the entrance to it, and giving it some presence to the street. In addition to that, we felt that the stucco was just a little too much. And so what we've done is we've added some wood texture to the facade, again, kind of give it some honesty and some integrity and some texture. And so that is obviously, you can see what we've done with the signage. This B with the inset bull in it is their trade logo. And so we've presented that to the street. We've also presented it on this chimney element, and then we've repeated it again, just in case you missed those other two, on the monument sign out on the street. And here's another view from the, within the parking lot, looking back out towards Lancaster. And again, we've brought some brick to the outside, created some kind of some panelization there, so that we're not looking at just a single solid surface. Brought some exterior lights to that, and then jumped. And then we've also applied some awnings, which are very, you know, it's very traditional solutions here to again give some presence to the building, and we've also applied some gooseneck lights to those to light those. Let's see, kind of. So here again are some images, just in case you haven't driven by that building lately. Kind of the back, mm-hmm. Pretty nondescript. We're not necessarily doing anything to the back, although what we're doing is we're basically painting or resurfacing the stucco. Mm-hmm. We feel that the white is not necessarily appropriate to the brand, and also outside of Miami may not be the best solution for any environment. And so what we're doing is basically kind of a, I don't want to call it modeled, but give it some depth with a kind of a two-tone paint solution that gives it almost a kind of a European old world solution. Some more photographs of the site. You know, for the most part, the landscaping can be maintained and improved. We haven't gotten overly specific about the landscape solutions, but the beds are very well defined. We'll try to maintain as much of the material as we can. I'll keep going through the sheets here. These are just the elevations from the model that we shot. Here's basically kind of the outdoor patio solution. Again, there's a small retaining wall that kind of defines that. Lancaster is a little bit higher than the finished floor of the restaurant, which actually works well because it allows the patio to kind of nestle in a little bit, and gives that combined with the roof gives it some protection. So I think people will feel very comfortable there. I think it's also pretty critical to the restaurant to have that patio solution visible, animated. I think it adds to the character of Lancaster in a positive way, and also acts as a good beacon of activity for the restaurant itself. Within the patio, you can see here we've got kind of a traditional, what we call a tractor chair. and then we've got, it's hardwood, I think actually these are synthetic wood tables. We've got a recessed radiant heaters out there to make it comfortable. Also, we have a fireplace that we're illustrating here. And again, we're not making a land grab to make a tremendous amount of seating out here. Again, it's just the 12 allowable seats out there.
And so let's look at the building itself a little bit, just a couple of things. As far as lighting, is there any change to the parking lot lighting, or is that going to stay pretty much intact?
Parking lot lighting will stay as is.
Okay.
So we were proposing that we had a couple of, this is a Toledo fixture. Again, it's kind of, it's a little bit of an industrial fixture with an Edison bulb. We have three of those that are on the brick accent wall that we were talking about previously by the entrance here. And then we've got some gooseneck lights, which are chasing the awnings around this corner. And then there's some additional ceiling fans that are mounted in the patio itself. And then the rest is either recessed or existing lights. There's, you know, we had to show you the beautiful existing power pack that is back on the service yard. But at least it's a compliant cutoff light fixture, and it's not necessarily visible from to the public.
Okay. You guys... You all right with the lighting?
Yes.
Yeah. Style lighting and all that? Okay, good. All right. The trash, is that going to be in the same location, same spot?
Yes. The trash corral is existing, and it is buried as far back in the site as possible.
Okay. I think it's shielded probably with a fence.
It's shielded with chain link and some woven components.
Okay. And so the facade itself.
Facade? I like the facade change.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah, I like the change in the color of the stucco. I like the window. Those are real windows, right?
Yes.
Well, it's just interesting because a lot of people say to me, have you been in there? I can't see in there.
Yeah. And that was one of our reactions too. I mean, they were kind of cropped. They're uncomfortable from the inside. They're not bringing light in. You know, there was a day and time when we said, you know, we wanted it to be inside and we had big, heavy blinds and everything else. And now today, we really want... People want to be inside, outside. They want the visibility in. Yeah. They want the natural light when possible.
No, I think the facade changes are really, really good. I think it just scales the building. It makes it feel much more intimate, which is hard with the building like that. So it looks good. The texture changes, the material changes are really nice. I like the roof lines, the awnings, the windows. I like it all.
Yeah.
This is a logo, so we're okay with this.
Well, we'll get into signage in a second here. Yeah.
I get ahead of myself.
All right, sir.
Keep going.
You're good with this?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, please.
Facade changes and all. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. All right. Landscaping, you said you're not quite ready with the landscape plan.
Well, honestly, like I said, most of the landscaping that is there is in decent shape.
Okay.
There's some of it that, you know, might need to be replaced. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, we saved enough space here to get some decorative landscape perennials. maybe some grass, decorative grasses along the patio wall, and then we would re-landscape with the monument sign. Mm-hmm. But for the most part, we're not necessarily proposing massive mm-hmm. changes.
Well, you have a couple of large, sort of large evergreen on the property, right close to the
correct.
Building. You'll just
correct.
Reuse those somewhere else?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, I think they might be movable.
I mean, it feels.
So outside the retaining wall on the dining area, those are going to be natural, or will that be natural plantings?
They'll be natural plantings.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. But are you going to require a plant? Do we require a landscape plan for this?
We're okay.
Yeah.
All right. Doesn't sound
it's
like
good. No,
monumental
it's
change.
Pretty small. I just, yeah,
right.
No.
But with right by the dining area, are you allowed to have natural? Didn't we have this issue?
It's on the outside of that wall.
Yeah, we'll talk about
okay.
that.
Yeah, but
yeah.
That's kind of addressed in Larry's thing about location.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So I think yes, based upon what I just read.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. All right. And parking lot signs, I guess there's towing signs, no parking signs and stuff like that. I guess they'll all stay.
Correct.
Okay. All right. Just somewhere make sure your address number, whether it's in a building itself or on the ground sign or whatever. So just be aware
street
of that.
Number?
Sure. We'll work with Ray and make sure we're making
okay.
the fire department happy with the size, the font, and mm-hmm. all that.
Okay. Anything else? Facade, the building itself?
Is there anything
say?
On the awnings? There's no writing on the awnings.
Right now, we are proposing that on the east side that we would have a little bit of branding on there because it is
yes.
visible as you're coming up the hill there.
Yep.
Okay, so you're going to put four awnings.
Correct.
Okay.
One large one on the east side and then three individual ones on
okay.
the north side.
Okay.
And you probably heard with the last application, the lettering can't be any higher than 8 inches.
Okay.
All right, and I think you're okay on your plan too. But just make sure of that.
You're talking about the awnings.
Yeah,
on the awnings.
8 inches
yeah.
on
yes.
the awnings.
Yeah, 8 inch max. I'm sorry, what's that?
You're talking about the monument sign?
Yeah, we're talking about that. Yeah. Okay, so you have four wall signs, correct?
Just double check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Correct.
Okay.
And the other, yeah, so we have basically the two B's, and then we have taglines here on the north and on the west side.
Okay.
That are on this,
mm-hmm.
let's call it a canopy.
They're pretty simple there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think the question may be is on the logo B, you mm-hmm. know how high that is from grade?
Okay.
It can't be any higher than 15 feet from grade.
15 feet, you said?
Yeah.
What did you do with?
I've met the requirement.
They did meet the requirement.
Carmel.
Yeah, Carmel. So if Carmel met the requirement,
yeah.
I would think.
Yeah, I would hope they would.
Yeah, so the larger one, or the taller one, is at the top of that's at 14.8 right now.
Okay.
The top of the, oh, good.
Any other guys also below 15?
It's.
They're both below
yeah,
15.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, this is the higher one.
Okay.
Yeah, and actually I have some sign drawings that we're already done with that mm-hmm. we're ready to go to the city.
To
so it's
yeah.
my cheat sheet.
Yeah, letter, yeah. Okay, good. Now that'll be internally lit?
Correct.
Okay. And
is the B lit? The big logos aren't lit, are they? Are they lit?
They're backlit.
Oh, okay. So something's coming from behind, sort of a halo.
Halo.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to see a big, bright, white B coming down the road there.
Well, they're going to be big, so here's...
Yeah, but I don't want to see a lit... channel light, you know, like a giant channel light or a giant, so it's going to be lit from behind, which will make it a halo effect.
Okay.
Right, so won't that be more,
so reduce.
It's going to really
right.
reduce that.
Right.
Yeah.
Rather than a bright,
yes.
white.
Right, the bright white
yeah.
light.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. So
blinding.
That's,
yeah.
about.
You won't have issues from neighbors or if there's a.
Well, that's it too. Yeah, residential's right behind there.
Right,
so
and we've got the auto body shop that's basically
exactly on the other side, yeah.
Yeah, which they're utilizing the parking lot right now.
Heavily.
Yeah, I saw on those.
It was like a used car lot.
Yeah. I mean, it's a big B. It's about 47 by 46 inches.
I know.
Yeah. I mean, it's square footage, 14 by...
It's 14 square...
Just shy of 15.
Somewhere it says
say
like 14 point something.
Yeah.
14.8 square feet.
Yeah. But their total square footage is well within the parameters. It's
mm-hmm.
a little less than 25, and they're allowed up to 50, so.
What's the material of the bee?
I don't want to misinform you. So I'm sure it's going to end up with some acrylic face,
okay,
because that's mostly what we make these signs out of. So it'll be acrylic. It'll have an acrylic face to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it'll be backlit.
Mm-hmm.
Acrylic.
Yeah. Yeah, and then these canopy ones. Basically, we're creating a raceway all the way around this.
Mm-hmm.
So those will be flushed and pushed through.
Okay.
And then backlit.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, so, they'll be backlit also.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Good.
They won't be haloed because they'll the cap.
Yeah,
because
the
basically
cabinet.
A
but they're
architectural
a nice size.
Cabinet.
It looks like they're
yeah.
like 7 inches.
Yeah.
You know, or, because that area is only 7 inches high, so they're small.
Right.
Yeah, they're 7.5 inches.
Yeah, I just want to be sure that the bee isn't too glaring. You know, so that's why I'm thinking about that backlit.
Okay, we can just make that in a motion mm-hmm. to make sure.
Okay.
All right. The okay, we all right with the signage on the building then?
Yeah,
you're right.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So you're right. Okay,
yes.
Why don't we look at that ground sign then? Or the monument sign?
Yeah, monument sign. Do we have a sheet on that?
The second
probably
page.
Second. Oh yeah, I can see it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's within code.
So 30 square feet is your max, mm-hmm. and you're right at 30.
Of course.
So you're okay there.
What's the lighting on that?
It's internally lit.
Okay. So it's going to be more back. Okay.
Yeah, we need to make sure at nighttime the only thing visible then is the burgers, beer, bourbon, and a logo.
Yeah, and it's all blacked out.
It's
so.
Black anyway. Yeah, so
if it's not, there's
yeah.
something really wrong.
Right, yeah. Okay.
What's the materials?
Again, that'll be acrylic.
The entire above the pedestal?
Correct.
Okay.
I think you're going to use the same base on that?
What's that?
You're going to use the same base that Carmel used?
The base is gone.
Oh, the base. That's right. They took everything.
They took everything
that,
right. that they could.
They took the
yeah.
base?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know what was there before.
Yeah.
When
well,
I go
you know,
to Google,
Kenny Rogers once. I don't know if.
Yeah, when I go to Google Earth, it's Kenny Rogers.
Is it still
or some
Kenny
other,
Rogers?
It's some old Mansard something something. Yeah.
Yeah. It was an Asian restaurant. It was a couple of things.
It might have been.
This will
Asian
be very
Asian.
Nice. I,
remember
what?
Denny's years ago?
Oh, Denny's. I knew it was.
Yes, Denny's.
Is
that
be,
what it originally was? I was
yeah,
asking.
I think that was the original.
Denny's,
yeah. Kenny Rogers, then the Thai.
Yeah, Thai pepper.
Thai pepper and yeah. royal Thai, something.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, we're all hoping and rooting for some better staying power.
Yes.
Yeah.
The what's in front? The green? What is it? Is that just a... Right, on the ground itself, right in front of the restaurant, between basically the restaurant and probably Lancaster Avenue, where you have the cursor.
That's just the landscaping, and forgive us for, you know, as we model things, we make them pretty simple.
Okay.
So
I think it's grass, isn't it? Is
yeah,
it grass? Yeah.
I can. We've got shots of the existing right
okay.
here.
Yeah. Oh, we'll be grass. Okay.
So the monument sign's basically going right here within this landscape area, and then the sidewalk. Separates that and goes along the building face in the patio area, and then it goes back to the landscaping here.
That
so we're not
like
we're not modifying any of that extent.
It looks like there's a setback of what, 24 feet for the dining area or off of Lancaster.
Yeah, we're not sticking the patio any further in front of where the building is today. So the setback
here looks like 24 feet. Look like 24.
Yeah, it's roughly that. I can't see if it's 24 or something.
Is that code? You're allowed to do that.
Well, as I said, it's not protruding any further than. So it is 23 foot 5.5
right.
is what it's at today from. From the line, the back side of the sidewalk, the line
okay.
of the right of way.
All right.
And I think we're pretty accurate there.
Okay.
Agenda positioning on the new ground sign?
You know, there was kind of several. We did actually have a discussion about that because it did
right.
appear that there used to be one over here. And honestly, we felt that was a little bit deceiving. Someone could turn into the funeral home instead.
I think you should put it right in the garage. Yeah.
And you know, this was deemed to be a good location.
Does it look like that's where Carmel's was?
It's exactly where it was.
Yeah, so I think that makes sense.
Well, it's got to be,
as long as it doesn't obscure,
right,
you know, hide any of the traffic, so that you're pulling out, you can see it. It needs to be a certain setback.
It's got to be at least 10 foot
from the cartway.
Yeah,
right?
Off the cartway. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I guess, yeah, it's a good question. So
right.
From the egress, will you actually have any, if you're looking at the traffic coming east, going west on Lancaster, will there be any hindrance to your revision?
Yeah, remember Lancaster is four lanes, so you're going to be seeing pretty far out there. They're not coming at you on the south side of Lancaster. They're coming out, they're pretty far across. I think honestly, the harder visual is seeing to the east because of the hill.
Is when you're driving west? Is that what you're saying? Or you're coming over, when you're coming from the east? Well, you're coming from the west.
Yeah.
Yeah. You come over the crest of the hill, and you're like, oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, just as if it's where Carmel was, their sign. I know we approved that location, but I don't know if somebody else has to check it again. I think it would have to be. Would it be you?
Yes, two of the issues we had before was the height of the sign in Carmel, and we wanted to see if we could adjust that. And second was that sight line distance.
Mm-hmm.
We worked through the police, but that has to be that 60-foot sight line. That sign was too close to the road where it was existing now.
Okay.
So we'd like to try to get that adjusted if we could on this, so that the people that pull up to look out both ways don't have that issue.
And what was the previous height? Do you know?
I don't remember what it was, but we did get some complaints that was too high, mm-hmm, at that, because it's so close to the roadway at, mm-hmm, that turning distance.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, if we had a discussion about it going to the other side here of the sidewalk, mm-hmm, that might solve most of those problems.
Yeah, but still you have to go through the police, right? When you go to locate the sign,
okay,
just so that it's compliant with traffic regulations, whatever they're...
Cindy, that would come through our office,
okay,
and we'd verify the police with their traffic safety. Yes.
Okay, so that's clear, right? Don't put the sign in until you get raised. Go ahead.
I don't think we're going to put anything in until we get raised. Go ahead.
Raise the man. You know, you're going to fool around that.
Okay. All right, good. But the design and the size meets code and everything.
Yep.
Okay, so the placement's going to be an issue, and that'll be resolved in house pretty much.
Sure.
So, okay, good. All right. Any other signage do you want to bring up before us? I think we've covered it all, but okay. We're good with all the signage then?
Yep.
Okay.
I am.
You're all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yes.
Good.
I mean, we'll have some very minor, you know, signage on the windows and the doors,
right,
and
right,
things like that.
Okay.
Operation hours, things,
right,
like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Keep in mind, there's the 20% rule. I don't know if you know about that or not, for window signage. You can't use more than 20% of the available window signage for advertising.
Okay.
So.
Good to know. And we. Right.
I can't imagine. Big stickers of burgers in the.
Right. They're anti.
It doesn't seem like that would be brand consistent, but then one day I drive by and there's a huge martini glass filling the window or something.
Right.
Like that.
No, we're not going to have happy hour,
right,
martinis in the, okay, in the window.
The other thing is no A-frame signs or sandwich board signs. Those are against code. Okay. All right.
I can speak for what I know now, but in 2 years when they do something, I can't control them.
Right.
But it's not in their repertoire at the moment. Mm-hmm.
It looks good. It's going to be, I think it's going to be a nice addition. I'll be happy to see it open.
Yeah.
When do you think that might happen?
Right now, we're probably looking towards the end of summer.
Okay.
All right,
so
good.
I can't say much more than that right now. We're working with one of the local contractors, Forest Grove, on getting them signed up, and then we got to get through Ray.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. So we're not done with him just yet, because Jim's here also for the outside dining.
Okay.
So.
Oh, yeah. Let's do it.
All right, good. So why don't you tell us what you have in mind then for the patio area?
All right, let's see. So as we discussed before, we're basically utilizing this area on the side of the building. So we've got just under 31 feet by 11 foot 8 as the dimensions of that. We're proposing no more than 12 seats out there. I think I actually have a better plan. That's probably a better better plan for that. And what we're illustrating here is we've got a man door here, and then we've got some bifold doors that open up directly to the inside so that we get this space, kind of an indoor-outdoor space. We propose that we have some radiant heaters that are up in the ceiling and fans, so we've got kind of both ends of the spectrum covered from summer into what we'll call shoulder season, try to make it as comfortable out there as we can, but we like people obviously sitting outside. During the summer, you know, hot days, these windows will most likely be closed. We like to have these indoor-outdoor spaces, but we understand and design our mechanical systems to kind of deal with those. We keep the building always at a little bit of positive pressure, but, you know, when it's 95 degrees out and 80% humidity, we expect our operators to keep those closed so that we're not being energy inefficient. And so what we've done basically is position some tables around the perimeter there. Again, we're just trying to get some amount of patio. We feel it's very critical to the concept and to the location to make it successful.
Oh, yeah, it makes it so much more inviting.
How high above grade will the patio be?
It will actually be below grade. So you can see here that the when you come all the way around to the entrance, you're going to be flush. Yeah. But then as you walk back towards Lancaster, we've got basically a 30-inch, actually I think it's 36-inch tall wall, which will give it about 6 inches of freeboard when it's facing Lancaster. So there'll be very little of this wall visible from Lancaster, and virtually none of it will be visible if we get it well landscaped. Mm-hmm. So it's, you know, it varies from zero to 36 for the height of that wall, and below grade it's 30 inches here to flush here.
Will you have any issues with drainage?
Basically what we've done is we've sloped the slab. It's not a big area. We sloped the slab and we've left a scupper back out here to get it back into conformance with the grading permit that was previously issued. And again, it's covered. So we shouldn't see torrential downfalls or downpours that are hitting it.
So the patio is going to have the cover?
Correct.
Right, okay. So that's all protected. So there's no need for umbrellas in that location.
Correct.
Okay. All right.
You said there's going to be landscaping along that retaining wall. My only thought is somebody running through there at night, which who is it that's going to be doing that? Whatever. But if you had some plant material along there that would keep someone from falling down those 30 inches, that's why I'd like to see that carefully landscaped.
Correct.
I don't know if there's some other restriction that's going to come up as we discuss, but that's just
And actually the 30 inches only happens out here. It's less so than here, so
along that short section along Lancaster, right?
Correct.
Yeah, that's the only part. You always have to think about, it's always going to be some kid, you know. Okay, just wanted to mention that.
Yeah, and you know, it's enough of a distance that it's obvious. You know,
yep.
we have trip fall issues when it's less obvious, when mm-hmm. it's 6 inches or thereabouts.
Well, how many inches do you say it's going to be up above the grade, that wall?
So this would be 30 inches out at the Lancaster side.
Oh, on the Lancaster side. I'm sorry, I misunderstood. I thought it didn't have that much exposure. Good. Okay. Then it's visible. For some reason,
I'm not sure if we're saying the same thing. Let me go back to the elevation here and make sure we're all saying the same thing. So this probably shows it best. So we're flush over here at the entrance.
Mm-hmm.
This wall is 36 inches tall.
Yep.
And it's coming down to, you know, here we're showing more like 12. It might be more like 8 inches over here mm-hmm. at the Lancaster side.
So that's the part I'm thinking about. On the inside of the dining area, it's mm-hmm. 30-some inches. But on the outside, on the Lancaster side, it's maybe you only have this 12 inches exposed.
Right.
And I don't expect anything to happen, but I just wanted to know.
Right.
The I can see some plants planned for around there.
And it's kind of twofold in the fact that we would have turf there,
mm-hmm.
And then we would also have landscaping up against the fence.
Good.
So someone would really have to have.
That'd be good.
They would be just and fine.
Mm-hmm.
And how high will be the retaining wall on the inside of the dining area?
36 inches.
36.
And so we basically set that based off of table height, and we want a little bit of freeboard.
What's the interior, the inside seating?
I'm sorry?
How many seats on the inside of the restaurant?
Get back to my cheat sheet here. So right now, we're saying we have 195 indoor
seats. Okay, great. You're well within the number of seatings.
And under the code, pedestrian barrier should be at least 36 inches.
Pardon me?
That wall under code should be at least 36 inches. We'll call that a pedestrian barrier. So it kind of buffers.
For liquor code?
So you're fine.
Yes, we're good. We're good. Yeah, okay, great. Got it. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Jim, let's just look at the chairs and the tables for a second.
Sorry, I was just double-checking the seating number. I'm sorry. It was, again, I didn't bring my peepers. It's 165, not 195 inside. So that's in our indoor seats, 165 and 12 outside.
You're still well within. It doesn't really matter once you get there.
All right, patio furniture. So we intentionally selected an all-metal chair. We find these very durable on the outside. It's a light chair, but not too heavy, or heavy enough that it's not blowing around. Mm-hmm. It's a very durable chair. It's been around for a while. And then the table it's a Gar product. They're probably the best restaurant manufacturer of furniture out there. So it's very durable.
Good. Okay, you guys. All right, with the chairs.
What is the material? Is that metal? Or?
Metal.
That's metal.
Metal. Okay. Yeah, that's great.
Okay. You're good with that.
I'm good with that. Yeah, okay. I like it.
Yeah, and we're intentionally picking. We're red. That's our color.
It goes
color.
With your look. It's the style of the restaurant.
Exactly.
I think it's very good.
And it's playful.
Okay.
Okay. I guess the just a couple of things. Yeah. First off, the heaters will have to get approved by community development, and the fire codes. We'll have to adhere to the fire codes.
Yeah, and we've used these coast to coast and other locations. They're a very good product, and we find them to actually be a little bit more efficient than the gas versions of them, and we honestly feel that they're safer than the gas versions.
Don't buy them just yet. You know, run it through the office first, okay?
Ray.
All right,
And the fireplace.
The fireplace, Ray. I'll turn it over to you for the fireplace.
Typically, it has been no open flames, no fireplaces outside.
Is that open?
So, you said typically, so typically. What exactly?
So this is not,
basically, nobody has one at this point.
Well, I guess so. There's certainly fireplaces in this wonderful community. I guess the question I'm asking is whether this is different than a fire pit that might be an open flame.
I'm not going to get into that here. I'm just going to tell you typically they are not approved on outside dining as fireplaces. So you can submit it and we'll discuss it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Time is submittal.
But that's the flame is enclosed, though.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's enclosed by glass or.
Well, I'm not saying it's necessarily enclosed with glass. I would prefer it not to be, honestly. But it is within a firebox. It's in a rated assembly, and I think that's much different than having a coffee table that has flames on it.
Yeah.
Or some other piece that's open.
I don't think we have any of those.
If we had to, I would even prefer to put some kind of grate over it before I would like to see glass in front of it.
Okay. Well, we'll let that be handled internally.
Okay.
Okay. That's kind of out of our hands.
But thank you, Ray.
Bit, so.
Looking forward to that. That'll be fun.
That conversation.
It will be a conversation.
Great.
I'd love to see it, but I'll let you chat with Ray.
Okay. All right, and unfortunately, you're not allowed to put planters or flower boxes or anything like that within the patio.
No, again, we're landscaping to the outside of
right,
that.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. So I mean, I can't say that it wouldn't be inconceivable that we come back and hang some flower pots from some of the structure.
I don't think that's even going to cut it. Yeah, nothing with dirt, flowers. Okay. Anything. There's food out there, and they don't mix. So,
okay.
Yeah.
But aren't you having some Are you having some sort of plantings between the retaining wall and the parking lot?
Correct. So we intentionally reserved this space here so that we could buffer the retaining wall, so that we weren't necessarily looking at the retaining wall.
That's on
the other
side.
It's on the other side of the food service area.
It's not within the.
So the others that.
What was the issue with our friend Harvest? There they had the green wall.
Well, it was all incorporated with the.
It was inside the dining area.
Inside the dining area.
I guess.
Outside the dining area.
Even the outside planters.
You can't have them. Yeah.
No, but that argument was that they wanted to have the planters on the outside, right next to.
You can't have any planters.
Okay.
Aren't they one of them? Because I wasn't here for their presentation.
Yeah, well, they're back tonight, so.
Oh, all right, great, I'm curious.
So if you have any questions for Harvest, they're here.
But you're good, you're planning outside the wall.
Right.
We don't have to discuss it, yeah.
We're fine, because that'll be looked upon as landscaping.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I'll inform them that they can't have any planters inside.
Yes, yes.
Not that we've shown.
Yeah, that's been talked about, and we've gotten notations on that 2 months in a row, so, and it's in the code. Yeah, no planters, flower pots, anything like that, so.
I know.
All right. Well, there's a lot of issues with it, one of which could be potentially a rat issue.
You know, we ask you not to use that word on TV.
All right, okay. Rodent?
Cats, let's go with cats.
Cats.
All right, okay.
Crazy cats.
All right.
Okay, we ready?
I think we're great. Jimmy, any other questions for us, comments, questions for the board?
No, again, I've enjoyed being here and being part of your community, and we're looking forward to doing business.
So you'll be back, right?
Absolutely.
It's not it.
No.
Which is, it's only to visit Ray, right?
You'll be in discussions with Ray.
I mean, honestly, I prefer not to come back to see you guys, but I'll be back to see Ray, and then we'll be back to have a party, and then I'll get to see you guys.
All right.
All right, great. All right. Okay, David, you're all right? Any other questions for Jim?
No, so the heaters. Are the heaters going to be permanent at some point?
Well, they're going to be talked about also.
Okay.
Yes, they would be. They would be permanently mounted.
Okay.
I'm good. All right, great. Cindy, you're going to take this from
there? Sure. Okay. We have a list of things. So in the matter of DRB 2016-13B Restaurant at 372 West Lancaster Avenue, we reviewed the following. So the parking lot lighting is remaining the same. The trash location and shielding remains the same. The facade changes are approved, and that's stucco color and the addition of the wood material. The landscape, it's minor changes. We're in agreement with that. On the awning, there is 8-inch lettering, no higher than 8-inch lettering on the east side of the building. The awning should be fire resistant, and that signage is acceptable. Then in terms of the actual building signage, we approve the two logos, the bees on the two facades, and the pin mounted lettering that's going on the
channel
lettering on the lower roof to be, and obviously all the lettering will just the lettering will show up at night. The rest will reverse to black. For the heaters and the fireplace, that'll be a discussion with the township. We approve it based upon what the, don't we? Based upon what the township. I'm in favor of doing, of having, if the, I don't want the township to come back and go, we said it's okay, but you guys didn't approve it.
We'll say the design element is okay.
Yes, there's a design of element. We approve the heaters, well, the heaters, you know, and the fireplace, and the fans. Is this going to include the outdoor dining right now?
Everything.
In this motion? Okay, and we also approve the outdoor dining, the seating, the number, and the materials, the products that you're using for outdoor dining. The lighting is also approved.
So the only thing I would mention, too, is the ground sign.
Oh, the ground sign. It's approved, but with the understanding that you need to run it by Ray, who will figure that out with the police department about height and visibility. So you may possibly move it to a slightly different location. We approve that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
One just quick question for Ray. Ray, I don't know that we've had too many applicants come in for outside dining with ceiling fans. I don't think there's anything against it in the code book.
There really isn't. I'm a little, I got to be honest, I didn't quite study this as much.
Mm-hmm.
I have to look into whether this is going to be outdoor dining or whether this is going to be an enclosure of the building. I'm a little confused with a hard roof and all the other stuff, whether this mm-hmm. is actually an extension of the building, which would be an addition, or whether it's truly temporary and at the end of the season all this gets taken down and put somewhere, which I don't believe you're going to be able to do. So I'm stuck on whether this falls into outdoor dining or whether this falls into an addition with a permanent space.
And so, Ray, that would relate to fire area and potentially a dry head system for that area?
Well, let's get into whether it can or cannot be. So you're expanding the envelope is kind of what I'm looking at here. So I got to go back to the zoning officer and have him check that to make sure that now we're actually creating a new space within the building envelope with a hard roof. Technically, if it's outdoor dining, you take it down in December and it goes away, you put it in a storage shed. What I'm seeing here is you're not going to be able to take that down. So Now, I don't know about outdoor dining. That'll have to be a, that'll be a discussion with zoning and then with the health officer and with us at the township. The potential for this thing or the design of this is something the board could look at. If it, if this changes to an interior renovation or an exterior addition for more seating, for a three or four season room, whatever you want to consider it, then, you know, whatever design for the chairs and stuff will go away, but the concept would be there if this truly is a seasonal and it could be taken down thing, which, again, I'm kind of looking at this and thinking, I don't think this is going to be taken in the winter.
Well, I mean, the intent is not to remove the roof. So, the
but permanent heaters, fans, and all the other things, and
right,
technically,
but
technically, if it has a roof on it, but that's a discussion in the township as far as codes, not for design review. But
okay,
if the intent is good, we'll deal with the others later.
That's another issue then. Ceiling fans.
Yep, I just said I approved them.
Okay. Well, again, we
you didn't hear
approved
me?
The design.
I approved the design.
Yeah.
Yes,
based upon
I have no control beyond that.
Of the township,
yes.
And
yeah, based upon
inspector.
The township's, yeah, you know, ultimate approval.
Okay.
I think that covered it.
You did a great job. Okay, we're here. Second.
I second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Thank you, Jim. Any,
thank you.
Any other
thank
questions?
You.
You're good with us?
Thank you very much.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you.
It was a good presentation. Thank you.
Yeah.
Look forward to the restaurant opening up.
I know.
Yes.
That'd be fun. What's next?
All right, next is DRB 2016-16, Villanova's Shop and Stop, Stop and Shop at 807 East Lancaster Avenue in Villanova for two wall signs and a freestanding sign. Hi there. So I don't know if everybody's aware, this is the Shell station,
yep,
on Route 30 and 320, the Shell gas station.
On the right, that's on the right, right hand side, right, right, well, 320.
Yeah.
The
Hi there.
Hi, my name is Dave from Allstate Signs, Huntington Valley, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
So actually, we propose two channel logo, like a trademark for the company, because what we're doing actually, I'm a manufacturer of the signs. So we usually manufacture and ship to like over 55 states for the Crispy Crunch. But we are local guys, so the Crispy Crunch asked me to just apply with the permits and install as well. So we propose this gas station have two entrances from each side. So we proposed the smaller signs we have in actually in a portfolio in the company is put next to the door. So
okay,
you
want to put your plans out on the table so the viewers at home could see it? Do you need them? Do you need those?
Actually, I have. I provide a copy of the plans.
Mm-hmm. Do you need to look at one of ours? Do you need one
can,
to look at?
No, I have Samsung.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, so the gas station remains, but you're going to sell chicken in the gas station.
The owner will, yeah. Actually, they had small like a sandwich shop, sandwich station.
Yeah, so
yeah,
right.
He did for years. So he decided to actually make renovations so the sandwich and sell the products, the Crispy Crunch.
Okay.
And
right,
basically, like a sign company. I have to follow the company criteria. So we have like four different sizes. It is the smaller sizes they have.
Well, I went by on Sunday. The signs are up, right?
What?
The signs are up on the building.
Honestly, I don't know.
They're
because what we did, we when this was built, and we delivered the signs for the JC, and I can stop by to take a look, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, they're up. Yeah, they're
put them up.
Yeah, there's one on the front, one in the back as you come down 320 headed towards Route 30,
mm-hmm,
and then one mounted on the ground sign. So
really?
Yeah.
I don't even really know how to address this.
Well, just visually, just looking at mm-hmm it.
Is this how it looks right
no,
now?
No, it is straight. It's
oh,
not crooked.
Straight? Okay.
Yeah.
It's a Shell gas station.
Yeah, it's
right.
A Shell
okay, no,
gas
I know the gas station. Yeah,
yeah.
I just.
Are they, is it the same size?
Well,
the same size?
Is this
yeah
to scale?
No, you know what? Visually, it looks a lot better than it appears here.
Oh, thank goodness.
Okay, not taking into yeah account measurements or anything like that.
Yeah.
It's not that bad. The two wall signs I'm speaking of.
Okay.
They're not that bad. The problem with the front wall sign is that it's I think it's too big.
Actually, it's the sign actually smaller than the picture because the signs actually.
Excuse me, could you just step just a little, pull back a little?
Right here?
Yeah, you have a great voice. It projects well, but the sign echoes on that.
This is the first time I'm doing this.
Oh, you're doing a great job. Don't even worry about that. I just want to be able to understand you more clearly, and so.
So actually, signs smaller because they have like a 45 angle. The signs actually 46 inches by 46 by 60, but as soon as the law, when you mount the signs, it's supposed to be like angle, like small angle, so it looks bigger. But in real life, it's not that big.
So the larger sign is 46?
No, there's actually two small signs. The larger signs for the
business. Oh, you did the two small signs? You did two of the 48 by 38?
We did 1 3 by 4 and 1 4 by 5. Because
it's actually four by five.
Yeah, because this wall, when you look at this wall, is actually half like a 25 feet long. So, if you're gonna do smaller signs, nobody can see it.
Okay. All right. Well, that was one of the issues with the plans you presented, that the front sign was over 25 square feet, which is higher than the code allows.
It's 20. It's 20. It's four by five. It's 20 square feet.
He's allowed 25.
But the one in your drawing is larger than that.
Yeah.
So now you're telling us that the sign is 20 square feet.
20 square feet. Actual size, when you put a square, like some measure from left to right, it's 20 square feet.
Okay. So this one, and this one's about 12 square feet.
Okay.
Actually 10, because 10. We also put,
The little one?
Yeah, the little one is 10 square feet, yes.
Okay.
Originally. Because the owner measured the signs when they put an angle. So when they put the sign straight, actually, it's a square. It's a 10 square feet. We have signs 10 square feet, 20 square feet, 60, and 100.
Got it.
So they go. I can actually email you the corporate specification. Because
we should probably have the correct sign information on file.
Yeah, that's actually the measure. Yeah,
to the township.
Yeah, I will email it the correct. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So is the signage up on the monument sign as well?
Yeah.
It's all up there now?
Yeah. it's all.
It happens.
It happens. Yeah. The materials as a see-through material. Do you want to explain the OP?
So you can see through it at night? Does the
I didn't see it at night, so I'm assuming it is. But let's
so is are these signs? Do they have lighting inside them?
It's LED illumination.
Okay. So the only thing that can show at night is the words "crispy chicken," "crispy crunchy chicken."
Yes.
It has to the background has to have a film to make it black out. Does that work now?
I'm not sure. I can't.
Okay, so that would have to be corrected. Has anybody seen it at night?
I haven't.
You have?
No, I haven't.
Okay, so we need to know that.
I can see that.
Am I explaining myself correctly about that?
Absolutely.
Okay, so all signs have to, only the lettering shows, then they're internally lit by night. The background has to be black.
I understand.
Okay, so we need to know that, and that would have to be corrected.
Okay.
Okay?
The logo can.
The sun can stay.
Yes.
Yeah, the sun can stay yellow, because that's your logo. Okay. That's a logo, but the. So we'll just see the crispy chicken. Okay, good.
Yeah, basically anything that's red, I guess.
Yes. Yeah, the red has to drop out.
Red has to look black at night.
Okay.
For both signs.
Yeah. That's going to actually look good.
Yeah.
You know, the sun
actually,
will look better at night.
I'm not sure it's black, but I can actually.
We can take it down and put the film in.
We can actually send the guy, just put the cut out and correct it, put the black from the inside.
Great. That's
like
good.
Take 5 minutes to do it.
What else?
All right.
So we're okay with the size on the two signs, sides.
Location, and they're well below 15 square feet, so there's no problem there.
Okay.
All right, the gas station ground sign.
Okay.
I'll tell you the history of these gas station signs, and this goes back
a
while.
These are complicated, I think.
No, well, I mean, just the history itself of Radnor Township, and Ray certainly knows this. When Mac McCoy was chairman many years ago, we tried to have uniform service station signs.
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at Luke,
yep,
up near the farmer's market, the two Sunokas,
mm-hmm,
by St. Catherine's,
mm-hmm,
the VP near St. Catherine's,
yep,
this one here, they all have the brick monument,
mm-hmm,
the brand, and the pricing information.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think the chicken really is what the intent of the service station signs are. Plus, you don't have measurements on that sign, do you?
Yes.
The sign is
2x5.
Yeah, I'm not saying
the height from ground.
Yeah,
the existing sign. You don't have measurements of that, do you?
Yeah, pretty sure it's 2 feet.
Am I going to have, hold on.
I'm looking.
The existing shell service sign. Which regardless, like I say, I think the intent of the service station sign is not that.
It's not to add other businesses onto it.
Yeah, it's a service station sign, and it should just remain a service station sign.
I think I'm pretty sure it's 8x4, 8x5, because the shell logo is usually 4x4, mm-hmm. and probably 3 feet by 4 feet. Yeah. It's price signs.
So total,
it's 8x4.
Right.
So the problem is that the shell sign is already at the maximum height. So we can't add on to that. That's in our code that the signs don't go above 8 feet.
As soon as the owner explained me for all this, the monument signs is temporary because he pretty sure will apply already. It's going to be Exxon or 76. He over the contract with Shell, so probably it's going to be changed. It's going to be different rebranding. I don't know who's going to do it.
Well,
so even if he's a different station, if he becomes Exxon, still the maximum height from the ground to the top of the sign is 8 feet, and now Crispy Chicken extends it up another 2 feet.
I have to check. Yes. Yeah, I will check.
So there are probably two issues. One is the height of the sign, but even if it is within the sign height limitation, we don't allow any other signage to go on, to be added on to the service station signs. They can only say what they are, like Shell and their, or Exxon or BP, not and coffee and restaurant in this. So I know you probably, that's probably, it's up. That is up, right? That's not.
It is up.
Okay.
Yeah.
He should not have had that put up before he got the permissions. It's a shame to do that without getting your permit.
So I will tell him.
It's going to have to come out.
Yeah.
It's clearly stated in our code book under gasoline service stations, sign content, a freestanding sign shall contain only the name, address, logo, pricing information, and or telephone number to permitted use.
So yeah,
that's it. I mean, it's a service station.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, that's gonna have to go.
Okay.
Okay. All right. What else? I think we're pretty much covered.
Yeah.
Okay. And then when the ownership changes or the service gas supplier changes, they'll have to come back for new signage.
Yeah, because I talked to the owner a couple of weeks ago. He said it's probably going to be 76 Exxon.
Mm-hmm. Okay, whatever it is.
So when you talk to him, remind him that he'll have to come back for that change.
I will send him a mail tomorrow morning.
I mean, sometimes I know people don't understand that, but it's just the way this municipality works.
I understand.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, any other questions for us?
No.
You're good with us? David, you're good?
Okay.
Any questions? Anything?
No, but we need a motion.
Mr. Chairman?
I'm sorry.
Oh.
I have two things.
Yes.
One is, will you give them a time limit to remove that front sign?
One month max.
What's reasonable?
Is 1 month reasonable?
I don't think it is. They put it up without a permission, and it has electric to it. So let's give them 5 working days to get the sign down. Is there any other electric for those signs that are on the buildings?
I'm not sure. Because what we did, we shipped the signs to the wall.
Are they just placards on the wall, or are they backlit?
They're backlit.
They're backlit.
Yes,
LED low voltage.
No electrical permits for putting those up.
Oh.
So 5 working days to get an electric permit to keep those signs in place.
Okay.
All right. Since you jumped the gun, let's do what we need to do for that. So have your electrician come in and pull an electric permit, please.
Okay.
But I think that's fair. That way it gets, because
yes,
we don't know how it's wired. If somebody gets hurt,
mm-hmm,
there's an electrical issue.
Okay.
The township's kind of caught here for
right,
this.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
So you need to explain that has to be done when he says 5 days. After that, there are fines. So you don't. Am I right? Yeah. So you don't want to fool around with it.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
Right. No exposed conduit either. Right. That's all going to be.
Yeah.
Done properly and meet the township codes. And
I'm
stuff,
sure
so.
You are good at doing this, so you'll get this corrected.
Listen, we union shop, so we know.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure I'm not, because I see for he told me he's general contractor when he built the station, because we didn't put the signs up, because we shipped the signs, we pull out the permit, and the owner told me he got all the permits when he for the construction permit.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah, he said he went around the board, all the permits will power. So,
so we should send this letter to
owner. I will
hear it.
I call him tomorrow. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Because
they really got to hustle.
Back.
Yeah. Well,
for everything.
We can approve the design and with the changes that we've said, so they don't have to come back to us, right? But they have to comply with the township.
Of course.
Yes, just for the electrical, for the signs that are up, if they're within your reason, yes, approve them. We'll just get the permits for do that. Front sign comes down then.
So we can only approve the wall signs, the freestanding sign we're not going to approve.
Right.
Ray, did you mention before also, did they have to get a qualified electrician, that the sign company itself can't do the electrical work that you have?
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, master electrician needs to do electrical work in Radnor Township, especially on commercial buildings.
Right, okay. All right, good. Okay, so you're clear with that? You're okay with that?
Yeah, of course.
So David's going to make a motion here.
In the matter of DRB 2016-16 for the approval of wall signs and a freestanding sign for Villanova Stop and Shop, I submit that we approval for the wall signs, subject to, I guess, changing of the coloring of the, how would you describe that, the back?
The facing.
The facing for blackout standpoint. Aside from that, with regard to the freestanding sign, owner is going to have to go back to the Radnor Township to get approval for couple things. For the permits for the electricity, we're going to need for having a master electrician, as well as the for the monument sign itself, the most likely you're going to have to remove the top portion of the monument sign to be in compliance with code,
right?
Of signage code. Aside from that, I approve.
And we'll just make sure that the correct measurements on those wall signs are in the township office, and they have to be below 25 square feet.
I feel correct.
Okay. All right. Do we hear a second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Okay. Next is DRB 2016-17, the application of Home Goods at 550 East Lancaster Avenue in St. David's for two wall signs.
Hi, I'm Brian. I work for Anchor Sign.
Hi,
we
Brian.
Represent Home Goods. I must apologize. My office emailed me plans, so I don't have anything for the table other than what's on my
phone.
Oh,
well, we can loan you ours.
Yeah.
Why don't I give you? Is this the whole thing?
Yeah, it's pretty simple.
Why don't you use this and we'll share? Thank you.
All right, Brian. So, what do you have in mind?
Home Goods would like to take down the existing 24-inch letters lit by LED and replace them with brand new 24-inch letters lit by LED.
Oh, I have a big problem with that.
Yeah.
That's just too simple.
Is there a different type set or?
Nothing at all.
Why are they taking them down?
I believe because they want new cans up there for new signs.
Fresh look.
Usually we Home Goods, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, we go out and when we survey the buildings, they like to see if their signs to them look new or in good condition.
Mm-hmm.
If to replace the entire sign costs them a couple hundred dollars more than just replacing the faces. Mm-hmm. So most times they just want to take the entire sign down and put an entire new sign up. They get the newer LED lights mm-hmm. and all that, but so that's all they're trying to
do. So the illumination doesn't change?
Nothing at all.
So same font, same style?
Same font, same style, same everything.
It would be nice if everybody did that, because you know you drive by and some of these like, uh-oh, the O is out. But, yeah. Okay, right. I'm in favor.
The only issue is, and I actually spoke to Ray about this.
Is it too heavy? It is.
It's 16 feet, 7 inches. And I was down there looking at the site. Evidently, the prior tenant adhered to the 15-foot height, because you can still see a shadow of the old sign, and you can see where some repairs were done to the old sign.
Get higher then.
I don't know whether we let them do it. To be perfectly honest with you, I think in that location, you know, it's not visible.
It's not visible from 30. It's not visible from the apartments.
Yeah, and if he drops
from anywhere but the parking lot,
that's it. Yeah, and if he drops it,
it's going to look bad.
It's going to look bad, and then you're going to have more holes where the old sign was. So I would leave it where it is. And I don't think Ray had an issue with that. And I really think we're going to cause more harm than good. And we're going to have to rewire stuff. And I think it's just such an easy application. And nobody's going to argue about it, the height. And,
I'm in favor.
Okay, you're all right with that?
I'm in favor.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
What else?
That's it. Okay. Could there be anything else? It's pretty simple.
That's about as easy as we get. Anything for us, Brian?
No, that's it.
Okay.
Well, I think it's Cindy. Approved. Yes. In the matter of DRB 2016-17, the signage for Home Goods, I move that we approve the the plan is presented.
Okay, we'll just say something about the height.
Okay, though the height is above the 15 feet code restriction, because it's on the back of the building, it can't be viewed from anywhere in the community. We're going to allow you to rehang the sign at the same height, because it won't, it'll show less damage to the building.
Okay. Okay, we're here a second.
I second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, next on the agenda tonight is DRB 2016-18, the application of Wawa at 215 West Lancaster Avenue in Wayne for 3 ground signs, 2 wall signs, and a facade renovation. Hello there.
Hello, how are you?
Good, how you doing?
Good, my name is David. We're with AECOM. We're the architects, engineers
great.
For the store.
All right, so I know the Wawa down by the hospital came in a few months ago.
Yes.
And evidently, you're going around renovating all the Wawas?
They seem to be.
Yeah. Okay, good.
That's their intent.
Great. So, good for the economy.
Any preference on where we start? Facade, signs, anything?
I'm sorry?
Where would you like to start?
Why don't we start with the building itself, the facade. And
okay.
But while you're setting up, is this Wawa franchise owned, or is this owned by the company?
Every Wawa is owned by the company.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you love to get your hands on one, it is. Right? Wouldn't you love to get your hands on a Wawa?
Yes, I would. If I could own a Wawa, I would own a Wawa.
Yeah.
Heartbeat.
Okay. All right. So it's
okay.
Walk us through and
for the exterior renovation, essentially the stucco is remaining. We are repainting.
Okay.
Am I a little too far away?
Yeah.
You get me? We are repainting the stucco, taking off the stone from the front facade, replacing it with a new stone veneer. The front edge of the mansard roof on both sides is being removed, and we're adding in an architectural canopy. And then the signage is being replaced, but that's a separate issue. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, exterior vestibule doors are all staying the same, and the doors into the back rooms are being relocated with new doors being installed.
Okay. So the front's pretty cut and dry then.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really just painting.
Did you brought some samples for us, right?
Yeah.
That's a major water issue up there in that parking lot. I don't know if that'll ever be resolved.
That I do not know.
No, I don't think it'll ever be resolved. It just floods out.
The
like
three
crazy.
Samples there are the colors of the new EFAS that they are putting up.
Mm-hmm. Is that consistent with what you probably did in Bryn Mawr? I mean, is it kind
yes.
of the same?
Yeah, okay. The EFAS colors are consistent.
Okay.
And the stone veneer, which will be installed on the front facade and rear for the first in this approximately 36 to 42 inches of the building.
Okay. All right. You guys all right with that?
Yes.
Looks good, yeah. The idea, I guess, is just to give it a fresh look and
yes.
getting a little tired to buildings. And, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. All right.
Pretty sure it's not hurting the business model, but...
How about lighting? Changes to lighting on the front of the building?
The on-building lighting is changing. I shouldn't even say that. We're replacing the fixtures in kind. New fixtures, exact same type.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, good. Same location, same everything.
Same locations. Unless the only thing I can think of is, for example, on one of these doors, if we're moving a door, the fixture's moving with the door.
Okay, so. Gotcha. All right, so that's pretty easy. I noticed no change of landscaping.
No landscaping changes at all.
The trash will be in the same location. Any changes there?
Correct. Currently, let me confirm this actually, because I do believe there is no trash enclosure on the site.
Bob, trash is in the building.
Yes. Yeah. Interior
all
trash.
Interior. Is it really? Okay.
Yeah. Interior trash on this location, and we are keeping the trash from interior.
Good. Mm-hmm. The side and back of the building, are you going to do much to renovations on that?
No, besides repainting and refinishing the EFAS, no.
Okay. All right. And windows will pretty much stay the same?
Windows are staying exactly the same.
Okay. So pretty simple change to the exterior then?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
So will this be a mirror image of what you guys did in Bryn Mawr?
It's going to be very, very similar because all of the legacy stores, which are this style, are very similar, but it may not be exactly the mirror image. Depends on when Bryn Mawr was built and the styling.
But more or less.
More or less, yeah. It's going to be exactly what Bryn Mawr looks like.
Okay, good. All right. All right, we okay with the building then?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You're okay, David, right?
I'm fine with the building.
All right, okay. So why don't we take a look at the signage, and we'll start with the front of the building with the signage.
Sure. Basically, the signs are, we're keeping the exact same text style. It's just a new updated sign with LED light fixtures inside the words. The goose is a backlit brushed aluminum. Those for the sign. So the word mark itself is a red plexiglass piece with red LEDs behind. And like I said, backlit goose, brushed aluminum. Mm.
How about the size of the sign compared to what you have there currently?
The size of the sign actually will increase. They prefer to go with standard sign across the board. So we would be using the 42-inch channel leathers, which are here.
So the W and Wawa would be 42 inches? I'm
yes.
Sorry,
Jenny.
Excuse me. What is it now?
I want to say it looks to be about a 30-inch channel leather right now, only because of the size of that metal panel it's on.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you go 42-inch, so you're picking up 12 inches on the letters, and then you add the goose.
Yes.
You're increasing quite a bit.
But I'm sorry, this says 35.75. Am I looking at the right same thing?
I think you're looking at.
So it's, am I looking at the lowercase right here? Doesn't that say 30?
Lowercase, yeah.
Yeah, but the W goes to 44, but. No. So it's not 40.
I'm sorry, it is a 44-inch channel.
44-inch, but the small.
The smaller ones are
35.
Yes.
And right now, what are they? You don't probably know quite.
If the current Wawa that is there is a 30-inch W, we are looking at approximately a 24-inch A and WA. Mm-hmm.
What's your thought on the signage, the size?
The sign itself is not going to change. It's just the lettering, right? It's increasing.
Increasing the lettering and adding the goose logo, doesn't have.
But the physical size of the sign of the monument sign is not changing. That's going to still remain consistent. Right?
Oh, you mean the back, the whole, the backing,
the size of the monument sign. That's not changing.
Are we talking about
the wall sign?
No, we're on the wall sign.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Over the
front.
They're individual letters.
Yes, they are individual.
So they're changing substantially. I gotta say,
yes.
I feel like it's a little too big.
Okay. I would agree.
I have to say, I think that the size they are now is more than adequate to serve their purpose. And I know, like the neighbors who live in that area, that's been. You know, when Wawa entered there, you know, I don't know if you know that. From serving on the board. I remember from Wawa throwing parties for the neighbors because they were, you know, they felt like they were suddenly a big presence in the neighborhood.
It's still a residential neighborhood.
Okay. So I don't think it needs to be. I'd like to see the letters stay the same size.
Okay.
Yeah.
I would agree.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay,
and I think adding the goose proportionally.
Yeah, and of course, yes, scale the goose.
Sure.
And we need to make sure that the goose is no more higher than 15 feet off a grade.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, and I think we met that requirement down in Bryn Mawr. I remember we had a lot of discussion about that, but I know they fit it in.
Yeah. Okay.
So I'm pretty sure they fit it in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so, all right, so letters no larger than what's there existing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the addition of the goose. So that's for the front of the building.
And I would probably say we'll do the same in the back.
Yeah, I wouldn't go bigger on the back either.
Okay, so I'll match the front and the back to the size.
Well, wait, don't match the front and the back. Make, yeah, oh, I'm sorry, match to the existing.
Yes.
Don't match the back sign to the size of the front sign, just so I'm clear on that, yeah. Because that definitely shines at, you know, somebody's front yard, basically.
Okay, so I'll match the existing signs on both sides.
Okay.
I don't know this, and I'm only gonna throw it out. That back sign, because it backs right up to the neighborhoods, do they cut the juice on that late at night, or do they keep that running, you know, 3-4 o'clock in the morning?
I'm pretty sure since Wawa, I think they run it all the time.
Okay.
But I can check on that.
Mm-hmm.
I know they planted, there's landscaping, heavy landscaping.
Right.
I don't know what kind of condition it's in, but I looked at it when it first went in, some good size, you know, some good height to the trees. But I certainly hope it would protect the neighbors from that.
Right, okay.
Yeah, because it's pretty.
I remember years ago, Commerce Bank, when they were in town.
Yeah.
We had a major problem with that, where they had a sign in the back.
Yeah.
And it was lit in the middle of the night, and the neighbors weren't real happy about that, so.
Interesting.
Yeah. So maybe we can just look into that and make sure.
Sure. I'll definitely double check and see what they currently do on the site.
We don't want to upset the neighbors, so.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay, so that's the wall sign. There's the wall sign.
Is there any, I don't believe anything on the side of the building as far as signage?
No, there's not.
Right, just the front and the back, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So we're okay with that then? Right, okay, good. So the ground sign, David?
Yes.
Do we have a photo of existing or not?
In the big.
In the big thing?
Yeah.
I forget that. I'm not going in there.
Okay.
I can.
I think it's towards the back if you open it up.
Okay. You mean this?
Yeah.
That's the existing?
No, I think it's further towards the back. This one. But I guess it's existing.
Oh, got it.
Okay.
Okay, there's our current. I'm just looking at the existing. Go ahead.
Okay.
Sorry.
Monument signs and entry and exit signs,
mm-hmm.
they are remaining in the exact same location. The base is being retained. The only thing we're changing is the actual sign itself to the new style with the Wawa logo and the goose.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And the colors are changing appropriately along with that.
Mm-hmm.
Overall size of the main monument sign is not changing. It's actually retaining the same size. And the arc on the entry exit signs is basically being squared off into a square.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, there are no changes to those.
And does this reverse at night? Does the background drop out so that their interior, they're lit from the inside, right?
Yes, they are currently lit interior there.
Okay, so only like the word Wawa, the goose, and market can appear at night. Everything else has to be blocked out.
Okay. That's on the main monument sign?
Yes, and on the directional sign, Wawa and entrance can show, but no light, no color around them.
Okay, so only the
word. It drops out to the background will drop to black.
Okay, all right.
That is code.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I don't know how long ago this Wawa was put up, but I have a feeling it maybe it isn't. That isn't what it's like now. I can't remember. I think it is. I can't remember, but that is code.
Yeah,
so
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
If it isn't, we're going forward. We'll do it the right way.
Yeah, I was going to say, these are definitely older style.
Yeah, they're older. I think they're like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So we're good with that? Good with the ground sign?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the little detail at the top, too. I think it'll just jazz it up a little bit.
It's going to look nice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the instructional signs or directional signs
are being squared.
Yeah. So they're good again. Just black out the background.
Black out the background.
Yes,
and I think you're going to be fine with those.
I think.
I don't know what else.
It's going to look nice.
Yeah.
It's nice to have it spruced up. It's great.
Right.
I can't think of anything else.
Again, make sure the address is on the building.
Mm-hmm.
If they're done your remodeling, I know.
I'll double check with them, because as of right now, this is the stainless steel that is that plain tan background. It is solid and not.
Oh, okay.
It is not translucent. So hopefully they've already taken that code into account.
Okay. Oh, that'd be nice.
Yeah, I'll double check.
Just double check
to just
so we get that
sure.
done right. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right,
okay.
Good. and, you know, you probably heard us earlier, mentioned the sandwich boards, they're not allowed, but I know in locations like that, they seem like, they put them out for lotteries and stuff like that, so.
Well, just advise them.
You've been told.
Yeah. I'll make sure they're aware, but.
Okay, all right. And, I don't know, I think, what else, guys? What else do we miss? Pretty good shape, I think. Dave, you have any questions for the board?
No, everything was very straightforward.
Clarifications on anything? We're okay? You're okay, David?
I'm all good.
Ray, you're right? Okay. Who wants, you want to take that one? Okay.
The proposal for DRB 2016-18, for Wawa proposing approval to reinstall new ground signs, wall signs, and facade renovations. I submit for their proposal and approval, subject to that the letters on the wall signs will be no larger than the existing letters, both for the front and back of the building. And I think we also, for the monument signs and the directional signs, we'll still need to confirm.
Yes.
That the the blackout background material is blocked out from the lighting. So subject to that, I submit and approve.
Okay. Second. Second. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Thanks, David.
Okay. Thank you.
Appreciate it. So when's all this take place?
I would say before Memorial Day, but I don't think they're going to make that time frame.
Right. They'll be closed for a couple weeks?
They usually close for about 3 weeks.
Three weeks? Okay.
Yeah.
Great. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Is it Wawa in Vermont? Is that Radnor Township?
Yeah. Just makes it.
Really?
Yeah. Down to the corner, kind of where the beverage is.
Okay.
Yeah. That's the dividing point. Yeah. I think on the other side of the street is. All right. Next on our agenda tonight is DRB 2016-19, the application of the Velvet Shoestring at 183 East Lancaster Avenue in Wayne, zoned under Wayne Business Overlay District for a new awning. Hello there.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Avery McMahon with the Velvet Shoestring.
Nice to have you here.
So we are just opening up a second location on the same block, and we're just mimicking the awning. It's a little bit shorter, but mimicking the same as the 155 location.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be doing a planter box that's made in Lancaster. It's going to be on casters as well, right here.
Okay, well, let's talk about the awning real quick. Material, this umbrella?
Yes.
Okay. And any lighting? You're going to do any gooseneck
lighting?
Nothing
no.
like that? Okay.
I mean, there's the pendant lighting from there, but it's an existing one that's been approved from the previous tenant.
So. Okay.
Is this the frame shop?
Yes.
This was Art Moisture's shop, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And naturally, you're going to paint the outside and clean
it
up.
We're going to be painting it, just mimicking the brown color,
right,
too.
Right. Mm-hmm. I mean, your other store looks terrific.
It looks great.
It really does. It's just really... You know, it's been a lot of different businesses over the last few years, and
it's very nice.
Thank you.
I mean, it just looks like
I appreciate that.
It's a good fit, you know, to the town.
Will this be different products in this store?
No,
or?
I'm actually going to be bringing. So I'm not going to take consignment at this location. It's going to be more of a studio feel. So I'm going to do. It's a lot smaller than the bigger store.
Yeah.
So every week or every 2 weeks, my mom and I own this Velvet Shoestring together. So,
oh, okay.
In this store, every week or every 2 weeks, I'm going to be getting inventory from the big store and doing a whole coordinating vignette.
Yeah.
So it'll give people the idea that they can come in and buy the whole showroom if they wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be more
cool
of a boutique
idea.
Feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that'll
yeah.
be great.
Up
yeah.
New York. There's a mm-hmm. on the Upper West Side on Columbus. I'm trying to remember the place.
I don't know the name. I don't know. I'm not familiar.
I'm trying to figure out the name of it. But there's a place where you're able to just drop off stuff.
Yeah.
And and the creativeness in the showroom, they create different themes
mm-hmm.
just from the random stuff in the store.
Well, that's what we do at the big store now.
Yeah,
and
fantastic.
Then I'm just going to be getting grabbing inventory once a week with my
Housing
guys.
Housing Works. The name of the store is Housing Works.
Okay.
It's on Columbus Avenue. And
I bet they get great inventory in there in New
it's
York
like
City.
81st, 82nd Street.
I know. Then you have my grandmother's stuff coming in probably.
Oh, yeah.
No, you don't want that.
That's great.
Okay. That's really going to be nice.
Yeah.
I think it'll look great to have it finished and you know cleaned up. And I do like the window box idea too.
Well,
not a restaurant, so that'll look good. What?
Yeah, let's just mention one thing. The string of lights around your awning in the other location
uh-huh.
aren't really meeting code.
Okay.
So
do I have to do something for code or just take them down?
I didn't see them. Somebody told me.
Basically, they're not supposed to be up.
Okay.
So.
Okay, I'll tell the guys to take them down this week.
Right. You can do it seasonally.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, during the holidays and stuff.
Holidays.
Okay. Right.
What holidays would that be?
Winter holidays.
Christmas. What about Memorial Day? We have that big Memorial Day parade. No, I definitely.
I just have them lined up against.
Yeah,
them,
I mean, they look great, but
they do. Yeah. It looks great. Your whole operation looks really good.
Thank
but that's
you.
That's not code. So.
I'll have them take them down this week then.
Thank you. The letter size on the awning, no higher than 8 inch.
Okay.
Okay.
It's going to just be basically the same exact awning as the other one, but just a lot shorter.
Okay.
You don't want to call it the studio?
Well, that's what we might do some kind of small signage on the glass window.
Yes.
Very small, just saying studio.
That's good. So you're allowed 15%?
20.
20?
20,
where
okay.
is it 15? Where's my code
15, book? I think, is in plan business.
Okay.
Yeah.
20% coverage on the window. All right.
Okay.
All right, the flower box.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about it.
It is going to be made by the same guy who did our Lancaster, the one on the previous store. It's going to be painted black. It's going to be on casters because I know there's an issue with the water line here. So you don't want to have that covered. And that's not going to be covered at all. But just so it's easily moved and accessible, I'm going to put it on casters just like my old store, the original store. I have artificial ferns in the bigger store. I'm going to be doing mimicking the same as that as well.
Okay. I'm just going to ask Ray just about the flower boxes. sorry, Ray, putting you on the spot.
Is there a Bilco door that comes out of your basement over top of the flower box there?
Hard to tell.
I think there might
I think so.
Be. Okay.
All right. So if someone is in the basement mm-hmm. and needs to get out, they cannot move the flower box even though it's
okay.
on casters.
Okay.
I know I am taking a great amount of heat for covering up the fire department connection your flower box covers up on the last store.
Okay.
So seeing how I believe you have to put a sprinkler system in here.
Okay.
You're going to have one more thing on the front of the building, which is the fire department connection. So I'm going to tell you the flower boxes probably won't
pass. Okay.
Probably won't pass.
What if I did something that is attached to the building that has, I have to see how far it comes out, but if it's something that's elevated or no way?
Again, I think at the time when the front of the building's done, if the board would want to entertain that thought to maybe
okay.
cover a portion of the window or something, that may be an an option.
All right, fair enough.
Yeah, let's revisit that then.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't really know the time frame of it opening. We're
okay.
supposed to say May 1st.
Right.
Now we're waiting for the owner of the building to renovate, so we're kind of on their time
okay.
schedule.
All right. Well, tell the guys in Lancaster not to build that box yet.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah, they're not.
Okay.
But they're not doing it yet. So.
Okay. All
could
right.
you could you build the box on the side of the cellar doors?
No. Yeah, I was just thinking, could you do something on either side? I can't. Yeah. Where is the Bilco door?
You know, it's hard to tell, but
that's right here.
It's like.
I know. Is it this?
Right?
Oh wait,
right
you have a different.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely visible in
yeah.
that.
So
right.
here,
okay.
so
oh, it's over
so here,
right?
My thought would be is that if you build something here, and I'm just wondering, and as well, see, hide that hideous meter in front.
I know.
Well, but then again, you're gonna have
You can't hide it. Yeah.
yeah. Plus,
but
you're going to have
it could be a small
sprinkler
box.
System,
you know what?
Right?
Let's wait and see.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
If worse comes to worse, maybe she could just have a small box between the meter. Yeah, let's wait
yeah.
and see.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But then we can. She doesn't have to.
Small boxes right now.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. We'll revisit the small,
so
the small
we'll
box.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Later on.
All right.
Does the meter have to be exposed?
Absolutely.
Because you have the meter box reading here electronically.
This is the water meter, right? Is this the
water
electric?
The
yeah, but
gas?
Gas.
Okay.
But you cannot block that?
By code, you can't block it. It has to be readily accessible. Same thing as anything else, electric meters or anything else. So you have to have a foot and a half either side, 3 feet in the front, nothing in front of it. It has to be exposed because that also is a vent, so that also breathes.
They should make them better looking if they're
yeah.
going to have to keep them.
No.
Paint it black. No, don't,
yeah.
don't. I'm just kidding.
Okay.
I'm not going to touch it.
All right, so it looks like we're good with
let's approve
the awning.
The awning.
But yeah,
And then come back for the...
Applicant can come back at a later time.
But does she have to pay to come back again?
I'm not sure, you'll have to ask.
Do you have to pay to come back again? For the boxes that we couldn't approve today because we don't know about the finished...
I don't have an answer for that. That'll have to go through Kevin, the director.
Okay. I'd like to see it not be a charge, but...
Certainly I would too, so, okay. All right, you want to take this one?
Sure.
Cindy, thanks.
I might be able to handle it.
I'm sorry, any other questions for our board? You're all right? Okay. Lots of luck to you.
Yeah, good luck. In the matter of DRB 2016-19, the Velvet Shoestrings, a new store, studio, I move that we approve the awning as submitted and recommend that you come back at a later date when your renovations are complete so that we can revisit the idea of window, box, flower.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Do I hear a second?
I second it.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thanks again.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, next on the agenda tonight is DRB 2016-20, the application of Harvest Seasonal Grill and Wine Bar at 555 Lancaster Avenue in Radnor for two wall signs.
Good evening. Hello.
Hi there, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Hi, Rick.
Greg Ishkagan, Harvest Seasonal Grill.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And I'm Rick from Lucky Sign Shop.
Okay, good. Nice Great. To have you here.
Thank you.
Rick, it's Rick, I'm sorry. Rick? It's
Greg.
Oh, Greg, I'm sorry. Okay. Were you here before?
No.
Yeah, okay, I didn't think you looked familiar. Okay. All right, good. How's things going down there?
You good.
Getting some work
Mid-May
done?
Mid-May, probably.
Mid-May?
That's what we're shooting for.
Terrific. Great. All right, so we're looking at two wall signs.
Yes, sir.
Okay, why don't we start with the one that says Harvest, and we'll go from
the
there.
The channel letters?
Yes.
Okay. 14-inch and 7-inch set of halo-lit aluminum LED channel letters. They're going to be black on the faces and on the sides. Probably do this. They're going to be black on the faces and on the sides and have LEDs inside mm-hmm. pointing at the wall. Actually, they point at the inside of the letter and it glows off the wall. So no face lit anywhere above.
Right. That'll look nice.
I think so, too.
Yeah. It will. It goes with the building real nice.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
And they're going to be black.
Do we have any issues with this height, 14-inch and 7-inch for the smaller? I think that's well within.
Pardon me?
I think 14 and 7. 14 for the upper, 7 for the lowers. Mm-hmm. I think that's yes. fine in that location. I still think you'll get visibility from Route 30 with that size, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. So they'll pop. So
actually, there's a nice view in from 30 right to both of those restaurants.
Oh,
the one next
that's
door,
good.
Too.
Oh, good, good.
What's the height from the top of the letters?
To the ground?
To the ground.
I think it's like 12 foot 4 inches, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. All right, so we should be good there. Shape there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well under, yes. Absolutely.
Okay. Now, right, I drove by there on Sunday. You can see I didn't have much to do Sunday, right?
Yeah, really?
That's my scout day. Early in the morning, man. I'm out, like, scouting, doing my scout. They're probably
wondering. I'm looking for sandwiches.
You could tell people you're working.
Yeah, right. Yeah. But right now, you have kind of a black background on there.
Yes.
Okay. So what is the background material going to be?
On the building itself?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're not going to naturally put black letters on a black background, so.
Oh, no, they're stone. They're full stone.
It's going on stone?
Yeah, it's going to be stone.
Okay. All right, so a stone front will go on that
area. It's veneer stone, actually very similar to what the gentleman brought in.
Okay. All right.
Wait a minute.
Little lighter colored.
Are we talking about right here?
Right. If you look right now, that is all black.
That's black? So you're adding the stone?
Yes.
Okay, good, good. Got it.
Okay, great. All right, so we're good with that. That should be pretty basic. All right, your other graphic, we'll say, or signage, the flame?
Yeah, it's a wheat, actually.
A wheat? I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's all right, I said it.
Sure, too. It's Harvest. I get it.
Thank you. Okay. All right, tell us about that.
It is a PVC plastic stud-mounted building decoration, for lack of a better term. It's just an architectural accent. It doesn't mm-hmm. read anything. It doesn't light. It's just there for decoration.
And it's black. Right?
And it's black also, yes. It will sit flush to the building. Well, but it's not lit at all.
It looks nice. It breaks up
it's
the
not,
stone.
It's not going to be lit?
It's not lit at all, no.
The only thing is that we look upon that is signage, and if we do, it's well over to 15 foot.
Correct.
Max. So that's the kind of the question
it's
on the
too
table.
Too bad it's not your logo.
So how does that work? Does that depend upon the lighting? So if there's lighting on it, would that
No, I mean, if, whether it's lit or not lit. You know, if it's looked upon as signage, you can't be higher than 15 foot from grade.
We don't really have anything about exterior decoration in our.
Well,
thing,
is it signage or is it, you know?
I mean, like what was that place called? Carmel. They had that huge.
Well, they
what was that thing?
Yeah.
But it was their logo.
The bees?
No, the Carmel. Well, before that, when it was Carmel Restaurant, it was.
I mean, I personally, I think it looks good.
I think it looks good.
But again, I don't know, Ray. You know, it's a tough one. I mean, you know, what's to keep the next guy from putting a logo of a bicycle or, you know?
That would look good, too.
Right? I mean, higher than 15 feet, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know, the problem we run into is one does it and everybody sees it and likes it, and then they want to do it to their place.
Yeah,
so.
And they want some variation.
And that's a problem. So, I mean, I guess I'm kind of a bad guy, and I would say I think we're up on a can of worms if we allow it. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you can make it smaller and keep it to 15 foot, I don't think we'll have an issue with that.
I don't think they'll be able to get it under 15.
I think the bottom of it is about at 15.
Yeah, I think so, too. That's a problem.
I look where the harvest is. I don't think that's going to work.
Yeah, and proportionally on the building, it looks stupid.
Is it on either side of the door, too? You see the little, they look like it, sconces on either?
Oh, no, those are actually sconces.
Sconces? I didn't know if they were shaped like wheat.
I mean, you have a lot of glass in that building. I don't know if there's an opportunity to put it.
Etched wheat in the glass? What do you think?
It's possible, yeah. I don't think they're putting anything on the windows at the moment.
That's a good call, though.
It could look really cool, because I'm pretty much sure this is not going to get passed. I'm getting that feeling.
What if it wasn't a sign? What would constitute it not being a sign and being an architectural design?
Yeah, what would make it an architectural element?
Yeah.
That's why I'm asking. We don't seem to have any...
It's the gray.
But I think, you know, that's being wheat harvest, like you said, it's, you know, it's signage. Yeah. Right?
It is like an architectural detail.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't say this is the harvest. I mean, we didn't know it was wheat. We thought it was flames.
I thought it was flame.
Yeah. I'm going to say I was in with you.
Okay.
Can I ask a question? Can you look at that as if was it there, and can they take it when they go away? Why are they here in front of you asking to put it up? Because it's a sign.
Right, because it's a sign.
Because it's a sign. It's part of a logo. It's part of a sign. It's part of whatever was
in
there.
Well, if it's a logo, it can't be above 15 feet.
Yeah, so
we
that
did let Carmel
that was,
put theirs above 15 feet.
No,
don't we?
No, Carmel.
That huge thing on the side?
No, because they're probably in the same spot that burgers and beer was. You know,
yeah, you're right. Yeah. You're right. I'm sorry. Yeah. You're right. Mm-hmm. Apologize. Yeah. Okay.
And I mean,
so
it's going to go quite a bit above 15.
It's just too big, and it's a sign. It's not.
I think there's opportunity on the building
mm-hmm.
to keep it under 15 feet to have that graphic, like Cindy said, the etched glass or...
Yeah, we'd have to take it off that wall for sure.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, you can't put it on that wall.
Right.
Yeah. But you could put it on your doors.
Right.
I mean, as an etched form, or it could be, you know, something another way to display it on there, but etching would look pretty cool.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, unfortunately, I think we're going to have to shoot that down. I don't know how you feel about it.
Signage in the library.
I'm sorry?
Remember the library? With the signage in the library?
I didn't think it had anything over 15 feet. That's a low building, too.
We let that go. We did something with that. What did we do?
We changed the, on the vertical.
Yeah.
They were supposed to come back to us.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
We didn't approve that. Yeah,
that wasn't approved. But but that itself is exceeds 15
yeah,
feet.
Yeah, but, yeah.
So
I think it's going to...
I'm sorry. I was not here for your first presentation, and so I don't know a lot about the restaurant, but I do see this, the aluminum or metal roof,
mm-hmm.
and are you changing your side, or is it...
just the harvest side.
Just the harvest side.
Yes.
So it cuts off at the other restaurant.
Yeah, you can actually see that.
Here. See this?
Oh, is this the rendering of your actual...
Yeah, okay.
Oh, okay. I thought I was looking at an example. Yeah. I got it. Okay, that makes sense. Good. All right. Thanks. That's what I wanted to see.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to look great.
It's going to look really good.
The stone wall's actually not
up yet.
Yeah.
The stone wall's not up yet?
So I was there at 5:30 this morning. It's going to look great.
We had a job fair today.
In your building, in your premises?
Yes.
Okay.
And
in the lobby of the building.
You have other locations?
We have, this will be our sixth location.
Are they in the Northeast? Are they in the, are they all
we're
over?
In Glen Mills, Pennsylvania, University City, North Wales, Montgomery County,
mm-hmm.
Harrisburg, mm-hmm. and Morristown, New Jersey.
And you're right by the Whole Foods in Glen Mills, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Oh. I was part of that opening.
Yep.
Good.
Okay, so that's
all right,
cool.
So
all right,
I think unfortunately we're probably going to have to shoot that down, but... Like we said, there's ample opportunity, I think, in other locations
mm-hmm.
within the building to
yeah.
To add that. And
it's Cool logo.
Yeah, I think, again, it, you know, you're going to have to come back before us if you want to add it, pay us another visit.
But if you want to etch it in the glass, you don't have to come before us. If you want to put it in your glass doors.
Okay, well, I think that's fair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Any other questions for us, guys? You all right?
Is there anything we can do besides keep it under 15 feet to have that allowed?
No.
No.
I don't think so.
All right.
Yeah.
Sorry. Thank you for asking.
Absolutely.
It's kind of a shame the building's so huge.
I know.
You know, we need to.
It really. But I do think that stone does look good. It'll look good without it. You know, it'll still look good. Your entrance, it looks really nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, you changed it. You played around the lighting above that, which is still beautiful with a beautiful stone in lieu of the
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's going to look really good.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, I do like the entrance. I like the arch. I think it's going to look great.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Great.
I don't think it'll even be missed.
All right. Who wants your turn?
Yep. Okay. With regard to the submission of proposal DRB 2016-20 Harvest Seasonal Grill and Wine Bar, for submission to approve the wall signs. I recommend the submission be approved. However, the wheat sign above the entrance, we recommend that it should be removed.
Mm-hmm. Or denied.
Or denied.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Do we hear a second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Do we need to say that we do approve etching on the doors if you want to do that for your logo?
Thank you very much.
Okay. Great.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think the library. I think
so we told the library they're coming back, right?
Yeah.
Boy, Marty's been here all night.
Okay.
Good sport.
Our last item on the agenda tonight is DRB 2016-21. The application of Autograph Rosserie at 503 West Lancaster Avenue in Wayne for outside dining.
This place looks great.
Yeah, we're almost finished.
Yeah.
Have you guys driven by or driven
past
pretty good?
Of course I did.
In?
Sunday morning.
I mean, the man does.
I was on the Sunday morning.
Okay, I'm just going to tell you the truth. I walked in.
I think I'm
they let me walk in.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. What? Well, it wasn't this Sunday morning. It was a few days. It was like maybe a week or so.
Furniture Scott was starting to get delivered on Monday.
Oh, no, I didn't see that, but I just saw the tree. Did you see the tree?
You
look in the window?
No.
Is that supposed to be a secret?
No, it's not.
Oh, good, because I could see it through the window, so I figured it wasn't a secret. It looks very cool. I think it's...
Yeah, what we're doing here is obviously you see the
Marty, is this the first time you've come before this board for this restaurant?
No, I was here.
You might
have, I was probably away because I just want to make sure
away.
That you got
we
to
here
talk
for
about
signage.
It. Yep, I was
and,
not here.
And the fencing that
right.
Okay.
Cover up the HVAC units.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously we're submitting furniture samples. The inspiration for the outdoor patio is Ralph Lauren in Paris, which is this collection of photographs. You see the layout on the top top picture with furniture selections in the middle here. There's 30 seats. We took over and are using the existing patio,
mm-hmm.
Which they used for Lamaze, George's,
all the
peppercorn,
things.
All of the above. So nothing's been changed there.
So you're... Interior seating is how much?
Our interior seating is 160.
160, okay.
Yep.
So you're
so
within, a,
yep.
yeah.
One,
you're within
you know,
a 25% rule.
25%,
so.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a really well-defined little patio, too.
Yeah, and it was always, yeah. It was never really utilized.
It was kind of messy.
Yeah, it was messy. The furniture was sort of broken down,
mm-hmm.
and the area wasn't well-maintained. So I think that's also what they cleaned up substantially.
Okay, good. All right, so why don't we look at the chairs, the tables, and
mm-hmm.
the umbrellas.
Okay.
Take a look at those.
So the chairs are a black wrought iron chair with a cobalt blue cushion, which is the cushions, the sample of the cushion is there. Obviously, the outdoor heaters, the heaters are propane
mm-hmm.
Individual tanks.
Okay, again, Ray's going to have to approve that within the community development office. Any heaters or anything like that, Ray, that'll be looked upon?
We do have heaters in Wayne, don't we?
Yes. All items must meet fire code and building codes, and whatever is in our code for what's there. So it's a triple layer of protection, and certain heaters are allowed in certain locations, certain ways, certain kinds. It's not a one size fits all, and that's what we just say. It's got to meet all the codes.
Okay.
Is there anything I need to know, Ray, as it relates to propane or, that's, I think what we're using is a typical.
Here again, that's more of a outside this issue, but it gets into seating layout, safety of seats, means of egress, heaters close to the building, heaters close to umbrellas, and all the other things that fall into the fire code. So it's going to have to be a sightseeing deal to get a look at things
now,
generally and how we're going to position it.
Heaters right now, by the time we get it open, we're just finishing up construction now, and we're just starting to do the decoration. So I think that at some point, I'm not worried about heaters going into May, June, July.
Right.
So you see wrought iron tables, assortment of different shapes and sizes, obviously apropos to the size of table. The umbrellas being blue, and the infamous blue planters, which it sounds like there's been a lot of activity.
Got a lot of planter talk here.
Yeah, I guess you heard the bad news earlier tonight, right?
I've heard a substantial amount of planter talk.
Okay.
Now, I do have a question about planters, though I'm not recommending this, but if someone came with a planter, but they want to do artificial, like a fake topiary without dirt in it, would that be acceptable?
So if I take my cigarette butt or my food and dump it in there, do I have fake cats to come and eat that, or?
Thank you for using the word cats.
Thank you.
I understand.
Thanks for asking.
On this side of the wall here, there's a lot of landscaping.
Yes.
So obviously that's an area that will sort of.
Yeah, that's enrich. It defines it nicely, yeah.
Yeah, under prohibitive barriers, flower pots, planters, and other ornamental containers. So right in the code. So, yeah.
Okay, I think the furniture looks great. It's really nice. It fits it certainly fits the overall design of the brand, the whole.
Okay, so it's a fire retardant umbrella.
Correct.
No advertising, no logos, correct. No nothing on the umbrellas. Okay. All right. So,
are you going to resurrect the fountain? Will there be a fountain?
There is a fountain there.
Yeah.
So the plan is to get it started again. It had been inoperable for a bunch of years.
I'm sure.
So we haven't tackled that. We've cleaned it up, painted it, so we'll have to bring people who do that to get that up and running. It was really in a state of disrepair.
I'd eaten there in the last, probably not the last restaurant, but all the ones before that. And is this how the patio looks now? You redid the brick, or you just cleaned it up?
We took up the brick. It was very uneven. We took it up. We cleaned it. We replaced it. We reset all of the bricks, but
looks
we
good.
Used the existing bricks that were there. They had that sort of French antique feeling to it.
Fits nicely. Good.
Okay. You probably heard us mention also with the other applicants tonight that the cushion material on the chairs, that'll have to get approved too.
Yeah, it's all flame. It's commercial grade, flame retarded.
Okay.
It meets all the same codes that we do inside.
Okay, good. So I'm sure they'll take a look at it just to play it safe. So, okay good. All right. Pretty cut and dry, David.
It's pretty straightforward.
It really is. Mm-hmm. I think, with this outside dining, and everybody keeps stretching it and trying to do more and more. But I think the bottom line is basically the outside dining, chairs, tables, umbrellas.
Yeah.
I mean, keep it simple, no pots, no trees, no, I think that's what it really is.
Yeah.
It's just an area to go out and eat. It's not to be another adjacent building on the building or whatever.
It's a big plus to the whole Wayne, the ambiance of Wayne as a community, though, to have that. When people see people sitting outside, it draws other people.
Well, what
it does.
Is it certainly takes in this warmer months. It sucks people from inside. And
out.
If the weather's nice, they want to be outside.
Sure,
if they have
a
choice.
So if it's 40 degrees, my husband wants to sit outside.
A beautiful evening,
yeah.
If they have a choice,
right.
They prefer to be outside.
Right. I think that, the main thing that I look and if I could speak for Ray and the other fellows here, it does create problems with health issues, tripping issues, you know, heaters that maybe somebody could get
really,
burned.
I mean, well, I think we have good code and things are in place, but we can't, you know, like control everything. Like, well, we can't have that. Someone might trip, you know, I mean,
well, we have to look at that though,
but we do have appropriate. I mean, sometimes we are afraid of everything. Right. We're like, oh no, that something might happen. Something happened.
That's today's world.
Anyway, but today's world, everybody gets to make their own choices. Anyway, this doesn't really have any of those issues attached to it.
So I think really simple is mm-hmm. better okay. and easier on everybody. And
it looks good.
Yeah. And it's still effective. People are going to eat mm-hmm. out whether there's pots out there or not, you know?
Oh yeah.
So, I mean, you've got beautiful umbrellas, beautiful mm-hmm. cushionings, chairs, and, you know, that's a draw to itself. So.
It is. It's nice that you have that wall. I think that's really nice.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And, I mean, thinking of White Dog in this, you've got two terrific locations for outside dining. Yeah. I mean, you really have the premier spots.
It's been a long process of construction, mm-hmm. obviously.
Huge changes to the interior. Really very positive.
You have all the millwork and...
I might have.
Yeah, okay.
Well, no one said you can't come in here, lady.
That's right. No one tackled you at the front door.
No.
Okay. I guess most of your signage is in place at this point, right?
Signage is up.
Yeah. Right. So,
when are you thinking? When are you hoping?
We are, furnishings have started being delivered this past Monday.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all of the construction is wrapping up. I know that the contractor will be contacting Ray shortly. They're wrapping up. I think they just got their electrical inspections, and so they're just doing punch list stuff now. And the designer's now doing
so her. May's
sorry,
a big push.
Marty, and just a little closer to the mic. Thank you.
Sorry. I think that's what the goal here is, you know, give or take.
Okay.
You know, obviously. It's been a long 2 years, so.
Has it been 2 years?
From start to finish.
From
really?
When you first
2 years.
Wow.
So at the end of the process, you're sort of a little tired. I want to give birth.
Yeah.
I think everybody's pretty excited to get into that space again because, you know, it had a really nice history in the very beginning.
Well,
and
you know, it's been a restaurant for 50 years.
Yeah. Mm.
So when you really think about it, you know, it's really a part of the community.
Sure.
And I hear all the time about what people really love about. There's a lot of sort of romanticism about the fireplaces, about they have a lot of memories there. So
who was the original?
It was the golfers.
It was LeBerge, Helen Siegel Wilson.
Okay.
LeBerge, and that was in 1960. What was it 50 years ago? So 1967 or so.
And it was really before people ate out all the time. So it was a very special place.
Right.
It was a.
And there weren't many restaurants.
Yeah, there weren't many. Yeah,
there
it was very like sort of considered high end. So, you know, so
it's really amazing that was there for 50 years. Yeah.
It so is. Are there upstairs dining rooms? I know.
They had upstairs dining rooms, mm-hmm. and right now we have it earmarked for storage right now.
Yeah.
So
that'd be great.
Hmm.
Okay.
That's great.
It's kind of nice to know the history, I think.
Yeah,
about it.
We're excited.
That's nice. Lots of luck.
Very good. Thank you.
Okay, great. All
shall
right.
we make motion?
Yeah. Want to finish it up? Okay.
Yeah. So in the manner of DRB 2016-21, Autograph Brasserie at 503 West Lancaster Avenue, I move that we accept the outdoor dining furniture as presented, the cushions as presented, and then the heat lamps will have to go through Ray and the township for code. Did I say it all?
And the cushions have to be looked at also.
Yeah, I think I said, oh, the cushions, they have to be approved also by them.
Okay.
But we approve the design.
And no flower pots, unfortunately.
No, you know what? And no flower pots and no sidewalk signs or whatever it is. That, you know, like this.
You know, I'm sure you're not going to put sandwich boards.
The sandwich boards, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Do I hear a second?
I second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for waiting.
Okay. All right. That wraps up our agenda for tonight. Is there any other business for our board?
I have nothing.
We're okay.
Nothing.
Mr. Daly, we're all right.
Any public comment?
Okay. Thank you. See you next month. You.